was a thrilling game that unfortunately ended in a loss for the Hartford Hawks women's basketball team, 61-56 at the hands of the Wildcats, University of New Hampshire. Coach, really just a tale of two halves yet again, and you guys start out very strong, nice lead at the break, and then all of a sudden it started to kind of fall apart in the second half.
Yeah, you know, we just don't have that maturity yet to kind of stay tough, and mentally probably more than physically when things aren't going our way. So we committed a bunch of dumb fouls. We didn't adjust defensively. But, you know, I think there were some positives out of the game. It was the first time in a long time I feel like we were really dominant as rebounders. Mm-hmm. I thought we did a good job of taking care of the ball and getting extra possessions. So we just got to get a little bit better defensively with that young team out there. New Hampshire's, you know, veteran guards. They know what we're trying to do. They know how to get the shots they want. So I think we'll be a little more ready for them the next time.
You made a change in the starting lineup. You went with Alyssa Reaves, who's been doing a very good job in the rebounding. She records her first career double-double with 10 points and 10 rebounds.
Yeah, you know, I said to them, I can't teach rebounding, you know. It's like you have it or you don't, or you develop it. And I've, you know, given a lot of guys chances to prove that they want to be on the floor. You know, Alyssa gave up a lot defensively because she's young and she doesn't know how to defend yet. But I feel like I can teach her that. I can't teach her to be that aggressive as a rebounder. So I'm happy with her performance. I think there's a lot of room for growth, you know, on both ends of the floor. But I thought her and Latrice were really solid in terms of doing what I needed them to do. And they you know, they could have made some free throws and, you know, maybe been a little tougher on the defensive end. But their growth was good, and I think they learned a lot from the game today.
Big test next week. You got three games in 1 week, a turnaround with a day off tomorrow. You'll play at UMass Lowell on Monday, home game on Thursday, travel to UMBC. How do you jam that all in a couple days?
Yeah, well, you know, I think hopefully the kids are anxious to get back on the floor. You know, giving this one away at home is just really frustrating, and I know they're frustrated. So we just have to be really ready and really sharp. You know, we're heading into dangerous territory where we're playing, you know, three teams with a lot of losses like us that are as hungry and desperate to find a way to get back on the right track. So it could be a really great week for us, a week that gets us going. You know, or it could set us back, but I think hopefully it'll be a week where we can get a lot of positives. I just challenged my upperclassmen in the locker room to be more consistent in practice and to have the poise and the mental toughness that makes me want to have them in at the end of the game, because they know how to play these teams. Yeah. And the young guys don't. But when I look up at a timeout under 4 minutes and the four freshmen are in, that's not a good sign. It's good for the freshmen, but it's not a good sign that our upperclassmen haven't been consistent enough. So I really challenge them to kind of take their game to another level.
The girls will be back in action on Mondays. They travel to take on the newest comer of the American East Conference in UMass Lowell at 7 o'clock.